Ants are found on every continent except Antarctica, which is ironic if you think about it because, you know, the word ant, it's in the name. Plus, ants are cool. Hello, everyone. Thank you for watching DNews Today. I'm Trace. Ants are everywhere. Seriously, there are over 12,000 species of ant, and they just sent ants to space in the commercial generic bioprocessing apparatus Science Insert 06. God, NASA and your names. I am fascinated by these tiny little creatures. I think ants are totally gonna take over the world after we die. They're really cool. Ants are excellent organizers. They live in nearly every kind of environment known to man, and though most of us know that there's a queen ant, patrollers, foragers, builders, and so on, ants are actually egalitarian. The queen isn't the boss. They've actually got no leader. According to the NASA documentation, no one ant directs the behavior of a group or ant, and no ant decides what another ant should do. They sent ants to space to find out how these tiny leaderless organizers would handle microgravity. They did better than humans did at figuring out how to float and then grabbing the walls of their container or each other, and they did it pretty quickly. Without a leader, ants have to communicate with each other to complete tasks that help the colony as a whole. A study in Nature explored hydrocarbons, which coat ant bodies to keep them from drying out in desert environments, but they are also used for communication. Patroller ants are usually the first to explore for food, so researchers drew them out, trapped them, and then placed tiny glass beads coated in the same hydrocarbon as the patroller ants outside of the colony entrance. They hoped that this would signal the forager ants that the patrollers were back by smell, and they could come out and get the food that those patrollers had found. It worked. This research has implications well outside of the Honey, I Shrunk the Science community. When engineers and scientists use nature as the inspiration for technology, it's called biomimicry. Honestly, it's one of my favorite things in science, and now computer scientists are proposing using ants' decentralized command structure to inspire new email spam filters. Researchers from Stanford realized that while observing ant colonies, young ants are surrounded by other ants, each with their own chemical scent. Over time, they meet more ants and they learn which are friendly and which are enemies. As they age, they'll eventually leave the colony to forage, meaning that they'll meet strangely scented ants, which they will know are intruders, that they should attack them. But no single ant knows every scent for every friendly or attacker. In this way, each ant has its own training and attack schema. Rather than training a spam filter with a centralized master list, computer scientists are copying ants to create smaller broken-up lists, which allows computer scientists to make cheaper, more efficient systems. Studying ants can teach us a lot about the environment, too. New York City is chock full of environmental stress for ants and also for humans. Researchers from North Carolina State observed 21 species of ant living in Manhattan, and they found the most common successful Tetramorium species E has evolved to eat human leftovers. In nature, ants will seek out sugars, fruits, meats, proteins, seeds, grains, and even other ant species when they're hungry. Because they have a lot of human food on the streets of New York, though, these ants adapted to clean up after us. They know this because researchers found high rates of carbon-13, a sugar found in corns and grasses that's common in human food. It's rare in the natural world, though. The thing is, other than being super successful in this really stressful natural environment, we don't know what this adaptation will mean for these little guys. Studying ants tells us a lot about the kind of environment we're creating for ourselves and the other things that inhabit this world. Will they fall victim to junk food's woes like humans? Because I hope not. It's pretty bad out there, guys. So ants have no leader, they got no formal training systems, and they eat our garbage and they clean up our streets. They are a valuable educational resource to learn about ourselves, our environment, and through biomimicry, teach us about any number of other scientific inspirations. But what's your relationship with ants? You love them? You hate them? Tell us down in the comments below, or you can hold on to your comments until April 9th. Because Thursday, April 9th at 2 p.m. Pacific, 5 Eastern, we are going to have a Google Hangout with Mitchell Moffitt and Greg Brown from ASAP Science, as well as Joe Hansen from It's Okay to Be Smart. You can RSVP with the link in the description because you do not want to miss this. It is going to be super awesome. DNews, ASAP Science, and It's Okay to Be Smart all in one Google Hangout. We're going to talk about science of stuff happening right now and answer your questions as well. So remember, April 9th, 2 Pacific, 5 Eastern, RSVP, link, description, go! Thanks for watching.